Hello everyone, my name is Frankie Carbone. I'm the head of the Character Committee here at Sheehan's National Honor Society. Today we have our alumni program. We have all these amazing alumni here today. And we asked you seniors to submit questions, and we have these questions here today to ask these alumni about the transition between high school and college and then later in life. So we have Mr. Mackenzie here today, who graduated from Sheehan in 1988. He attended UConn and University of New Haven, and he majored in economics. And now he's a national sales manager for small appliances. Ms. Gill graduated from Sheehan in 2012, and she went to Springfield College. She is a physical education teacher. Mr. Papale graduated from Sheehan in 2007, and he went to Quinnipiac, and he majored in communications. And he now is, he works for a nonprofit called DefibTech. And Ms. Brown graduated in 2018, and she went to Messiah University, and she's majoring in health and physical education. So as I said earlier, I'm Frankie Carbone. I'm a senior here this year, and I will be attending Central Connecticut State University to study computer science.
I'm Lydia Dellipoali. I am also graduating this year, and I'm attending Bryant University for undecided business.
I am Jaidin Kapoor. I'm graduating in 2022.
I'm Emily Jasinski, and I'm graduating in 2022.
And I'll start off the questioning today. Just I'll ask Mr. Mackenzie first, and then we could just go down the line with my first question. So I'm a senior this year, and I always wanted to take more art classes. I always loved art, but I never was good at it, but I liked doing it. So if you could go back to high school and take any class that you did not, what class would you pick?
I would probably take a public speaking class, because you're always gonna find yourself in an environment where you need to speak to people, and the more comfortable you are with talking to a bunch of people at once and just being confident in your statement and what you're saying is really important. So I think I would go back and do public speaking, because that's something you'd always like to have with you.
Okay. Best skill?
If I really thought about it, I probably would have taken anatomy, because that definitely would have helped me the first year at Springfield. Because I did not realize what I was walking into after only taking astronomy my senior year.
Mr. Pella?
Yeah, if I could go back, I would definitely take some sort of business class, business or economics, just to learn, looking at what I do now with running an organization that we started kind of from scratch and learning how to build it. I think just like a basic business 101 class would have been really beneficial for me.
Ms. Brown?
I took a lot of photography classes, but I think just because I like painting now, I think I would have taken a painting class just to pursue more of a hobby with it.
Nice. Just back to you, Mr. Mackenzie. For you said public speaking, so I know me, as in a lot of my peers and friends in school, we do presentations in class, and it's one of the biggest fears, I would say, for students today is public speaking. So you did not take like a public speaking class, you wanted to take one. So how did you get over that fear, if you had one originally? Well,
yeah, so the more you do it, the more comfortable you get. And in all honesty, I mean, I still don't thoroughly enjoy speaking in front of large crowds. But it's, I found that if you're confident in what your story or your message is, the rest comes easy, and you just try and have a conversation. So if you are in a situation where you have to present to a bunch of people, just know what you're talking about, and it'll go a lot better.
Great. Awesome. So to Ms. Gill, you can start off this one. Just I'm in the National Honor Society, the esports team, the Ultimate Frisbee team. I was in a decent amount of clubs. Were you in any clubs at Sheehan? What else were you involved in at Sheehan when you were here?
I was a three-sport athlete, so I played field hockey, basketball, and softball. So not really a bunch of time for clubs to be a part of. But I was on student council, so I made sure that I made time for that. I was in German club, we didn't really meet very often, and I know German is not really a thing anymore. You know, with that, it's, I just think students, you should be involved in as many things as possible, not just one set thing. You know, colleges and universities, they like to see that somebody's going to be an active student on campus and that they're going to be involved and, you know, contributing to campus. So starting it here is a good idea for, you know, anything in the future.
Super Valley?
Yeah, I was very, very focused on basketball in high school. And I played it year-round, and it was really one of the only things I did. And it's probably something I regret because I would say I wasn't very well-rounded. Looking back, and if I could give anybody advice, it would be to get more involved, whether it's in high school or in college, because what you are interested in high school, whether it's playing a sport, you just don't do it forever. And as much as you think you're going to, like I probably like was pretty small-minded to think I was going to play basketball forever, and that was the only thing that, you know, was going to matter in my life. Looking back at it now, I wish I definitely was more involved. The other, you know, my senior year, I got involved with the blood drive as well. But other than that, I was just pretty much focused on basketball. So I would definitely urge students to get involved as much as possible.
Ms. Brown?
I agree, getting involved with a lot of different activities. I was in marching band and yearbook my senior year. Well, marching band all 4 years, but then yearbook my senior year. And then I was on the indoor and outdoor track throughout all of high school, which carried on into college, which I think it definitely is important to become active in a bunch of different activities, because then maybe one of those you can pursue either in college or just have that in like your background later on in life if you ever come back to it.
All right. And Mr. Mackenzie?
Yeah, I was involved in a lot of different things in high school, football, baseball, basketball, student council. So I was, again, involved in a lot of things. But you know, kind of contrary to what you said, Mike, is that like I didn't focus on anything, and I almost wish I had more focus on some things. But it's kind of trying to do the balancing game where you're focus enough on what you want to be passionate about, but still being involved in other things as well. So, yeah, the more you can be involved with, the better off you are and the better time spent you have.
Okay. Thank you. So, Mr. Papale, what is, I mean, yes, you just said focusing on one thing, maybe you regret it, and then Mr. Mackenzie said, not focusing on one thing is, you know, there's two different sides to it, but what's a piece of advice you could give to a current student, senior, who's, yes, it's we're past May, we should have decided our colleges, but are still looking into what major they want to pursue and, like, the decision about what we have to do for the rest of our life, like, that big decision. Do you have any advice for us?
Yeah, don't, like, force it. I think so many people, like, when they leave high school and they go to college, they feel like they're, like, forced into something just because they have to make a decision. And my advice would be to, like, if you're unsure and it's not something you're super passionate about yet, you know, try a bunch of different things and see what you're really passionate about, because it's really hard to make that decision when you're 18 years old. And I know, like, what I thought I was going to do with my life leaving high school is completely different than what I'm doing now. I would say if you're undecided, don't feel like you're forced to make a decision just because, you know, you feel like you have to. Take different classes, get involved in different organizations, and see what you're really passionate about, because this is a time where you can do that. You know, the older you get and the farther along you get in life, you kind of have other responsibilities that you have to kind of settle into. So when you're young, you have a chance to kind of figure out what that passion is.
I think that, especially going into your freshman year of college, that it's okay not to have everything that you want to do in life. Like, it's okay not to know what you want to do. And I was lucky enough to know going in what I wanted to do, and I didn't change my major. But I think it's important to for people going in, I've already said this kind of, but don't have that idea in your head that what you're going to go into college, you may change that, and that it's okay to know that you're going to change that. And if you do go in, okay, wait, that is confusing. Let me restart. Okay. Going into college, a lot of people think that it's a bad thing to change your major because you want to stick to something, kind of like what you were saying. But I think having that idea in your head that it's okay to change your major and it's okay to try different things, like you were saying. And I think kind of going into like your senior year of high school, like for like all the juniors and stuff like that, and even the seniors, if you don't have an idea of what you want to do, talk to your teachers who are your favorite teachers, because most likely those are the classes that you're enjoying, and those are the classes that you might want to pursue later on in life. All right.
Yeah, I would say just to make sure that it's your decision what you're doing, because you're going to have a lot of people trying to influence what they think you should do or what they want you to do or what maybe what they thought they should have done. But you have to remember that it's your life, it's your decision. Do something that you're going to want to do the rest of your life, because you're the one that has to live with all your choices. So, you know, make sure it is what you want. And then the other thing is that it's, you know, college is, you know, obviously one of the biggest decisions you guys are going to make in your lives, and you make it and then you go, but it you don't have to view it as like a death sentence, like I'm here and this is the only thing that I can do now. Once you're there, if you find out that it wasn't the right choice, you can make a move. It's not, you know, the end of the world if you decide you need to change locations, change majors, change whatever you want, because like Mike said, when you're young, you have the ability to take more risks and to do different things. When you get older, you have, you know, a mortgage, car payments, children, whatever. You don't have the ability to take as much risk as you can when you're younger. So figure it out and try a lot of different things and do what truly makes you happy.
You had made the comment by now, you know, seniors should know what they're doing. It's okay if you have no idea. You know, I, you know, luckily knew what I wanted to do. And, you know, I had a plan. This is what I wanted to do. But there's people I went to college with at the end of our 4 years. They realized that they didn't want to do what they got their degree in. And it's okay to change your mind. It's okay to take a year off. It's okay to take a semester off. You know, I know, like, everyone pushes college and, oh, you're a senior, where are you going to school next year? It's not for everybody, but it's okay to have no idea, because you are 17, 18 years old graduating. It's okay to say, yeah, I have no idea, but I'm just going to kind of figure it out as I go.
So for me, when I was looking to go to college, my junior year, end of junior year into the summer, I was looking into occupational therapy, and that's what I was really going for up until the summer, until I started my senior year classes, and I took computer programming classes, two of them, and I fell in love with them. So then I looked into computer science, and that's where I'm headed to right now. So for me, my decision changed in less than a year, just before even going to college. So just to go off that last question a little bit, I know Ms. Gill and Ms. Brown kind of hinted at it, but your decision as an 18-year-old senior in high school was the decision you made to study like economics. You were probably studying communications. Did those decisions you made carry through to your careers now, or did they change, and you had to adjust to that, and now you're living with those choices? We'll start, Ms. Brown. You can start it off.
Well, I'm currently still in college, so I'm still doing my health and PE that I came in with. So, and right now, I'm not sure if this is going to answer your question, but right now I'm subbing, so I'm getting the experience of, like, I want to be a teacher and stuff like that. So if that kind of answers your question, that my life goals could still change drastically in the next couple of years, especially next year because I'm graduating. But as of right now, they haven't really changed.
Yeah, I would say when I chose economics, I chose it because it was a general business degree. It wasn't, you know, focused in marketing or finance or accounting, because I really wasn't sure what I wanted to do. So having the general, because I still took a lot of those classes but had the degree in economics, so I didn't pigeonhole myself in one specific area. But you do feel like once you have your degree, you feel somewhat aligned with an area that you have expertise or knowledge of that you really end up going towards more, but it doesn't mean that you have to stay in that direction. There's still you know, opportunity to move in a lot of different directions. Certainly you can't, you know, be a doctor if you have an economics degree, but you can, unless you wanted to go back to school, but you can do different things with different degrees. And again, it's about finding what you're passionate about and just doing it, because I think most jobs that I've had, I don't think I I could have done them without any degree. I think getting your degree gets you in the door at most places, but it most of the time it doesn't teach you what your day-to-day life is going to be like at a job, unless you have a real specialized degree.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm a phys ed and health teacher, so it's directly related. But after college, I actually struggled with finding a teaching job because it's very hard to find a teaching job. So I was looking into grad school, and I was looking at changing careers just because I was trying to keep my options open. I ended up getting a job, you know, so that didn't really happen. But still, when I was looking into my master's degree, you know, just looking at my options as if, what if I decide in 10 years, you know, I don't want to teach anymore, or, you know, this isn't what I want to do every day. So, I mean, that thought does cross your mind because it's kind of like I'm doing this for the next 36 years of my life. You know, so there's always like a healthy amount of doubt that you have.
Yeah, my path definitely changed. I went into college thinking I wanted to do physical therapy, and to be completely honest, took like 2 science classes and realized that I wasn't going to do physical therapy. And I wanted to coach college basketball, and if not, be involved in sports. So that's why I kind of went to communications, because I knew where there were some ways that I could be involved in sports if coaching didn't work, whether it was like sports journalism or broadcasting or production. And, you know, so I would say I do use the skills I, you know, learned from my degree in my everyday life for sure. But I think it's a balance of like the skills that you learn and also relationships that you build. That's equally as important, because like we've talked about, like getting a job is, you know, you could have a great degree, but it's challenging. So you have to, you know, build relationships, and once you get a job, use those skills.
All right. Just for Ms. Gill and Ms. Brown, quickly, you both majored in health and PE in college, so, and you're still in college now. So when did you realize you wanted to study that? Was it your senior year of high school, or was it before that, even?
Mine was going into my senior year, like that summer. That's when I realized it.
So I knew I always wanted to be a teacher, and my senior year I took AP Art because I thought I wanted to maybe be an art teacher, and I did the PE internship here. I loved both, but there were some days in art that I couldn't do it. I just needed to get up and move around and be doing something. And, you know, Mr. Ferrazzi actually convinced me to go to Springfield College. So that's kind of what influenced my decision.
All right, so I'm going to be taking over the questions. So I know that I mentioned that I'm attending a college in the fall. So what are some challenges that you face in adjusting to your life post-high school? So I'm going to start with Mr. Mackenzie.
Yeah, I would say for me the biggest challenge was, you know, I was involved in so much in high school, and then I wasn't involved in enough in college. So and that's the one thing I would recommend, that you get involved in something. And it's hard going from, you know, playing 3 sports and doing something every day where your time is scheduled to the minute. You don't have any free time at all between homework and practice and whatever. And then you're in college and you've got a couple of classes a day, and then you're doing nothing. And downtime is not healthy. So while you're going to think, oh, I need extra time to do my studying, to do this, the more structured you are, the better off you'll be, and the better results you'll have. So don't be afraid to schedule your time.
And then just a quick follow-up question. Were there any, like, tips that you used in college to help, like, buckle down with your studies?
Honestly, I mean, I think everybody studies their own way. For me, I found the more I wrote about what I was studying, the more I retained. So I just wrote everything in order to learn, but not everybody works that way. So for me, that's what helped me. But try and stay ahead, like, because there's like, you in high school you may be able to skate by and catch up at the end of the semester, at the end of the week. In college, it's a lot harder. If you procrastinate, you don't get things done as you should, it's going to bury you. So you have to make sure you stay on top of everything.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Biggest challenge for the fall. I played field hockey in college, so I kind of threw myself into school and the schedule. But I think like the biggest thing was sticking to that schedule. So classes every day, practice, you know, homework, kind of making it similar to high school, I guess. The best advice I could give was still use a planner, like go and buy a planner, schedule it out, write due dates, reminders for yourself, and figure out what study method, where studying and doing work is gonna, you know, get you to get everything done.
Yeah, I would say the biggest change for me was like adjusting to, you know, like we talked about, you know, from high school, you're in school from 7:30 to 2. To college, where you might have a class at 8 a.m., then your next class might not be till 1 p.m., you might have a night class. So, you know, that was a bit of an adjustment because it's not as structured. So, you know, I think, you know, getting involved is huge. And then once you do get involved, is learning how to, like, manage your time and be disciplined in doing the things you need to do while still allowing yourself to have, like, a social life. Because that's, like, going to carry over for your whole life. You're going to get a job and, you know, you don't want your job to, like, take over your whole life. You want to be able to manage your time, do your responsibilities, and still, you know, enjoy the other parts of your life as well.
And then Ms. Brown.
I think the biggest change for me was not being able to see my family every day because I'm at a school that's 5 hours away. So I can't, like, in high school, I come home, like, in the morning, I see them, I say bye. I come home at night, and I see them, I eat dinner with them. And I think that was definitely the biggest change of seeing them every day to not seeing them for, like, 3 months at a time. And I think that my biggest tip for that is to just reach out to your family and your friends, like, keep contact. And I know for me, I call my parents a lot, probably more than I should. But I think definitely just having that in your head, don't not call your parents or your friends, keep in contact.
And then there is so much that Sheehan offers. I know Frankie said I'm also involved in a lot of things at Sheehan. I know we touched on this briefly, but is there anything you regret not doing in high school? And if so, what was it? And then starting with Ms. Gill.
I can't say I have any regrets about high school. Any situation, participating in anything, going to any school functions or anything like that. You know, I kind of did what I guess I wanted to when I was in high school, and I kind of recognized that if I don't want to do something, I'm not going to do it. So no, I don't really have any regrets.
Yeah, I mean, I really enjoyed my experience in high school. Looking at it now, like, I do wish I maybe did some more clubs. I wish I played golf because I didn't realize, you know, when you're older, you're going to play golf and other sports. But and it's really hard, so you're better off starting when you're a young kid. But yeah, I mean, I wish I got involved in some, like, non-athletic club and activities.
Ms. Brown.
I don't think I have any regrets, kind of going off of what Ms. Gill said. I did, like, what I wanted to do, and I felt that I wasn't just, like, in sport, but I also did marching band, and I also did, like, art-related stuff, so I don't think I have any regrets.
Ms. Mackenzie.
Yeah, same kind of thing. I mean, I was involved with a lot, and I don't think there's any one thing I wish I did do other than maybe, like, again, specialize in something more than doing too much. So, but it's not a major regret. It's just I wish I focused on some things more than others, but was involved in enough.
And then the next question is, do you think college is worth it, or do you think that there is another route? Starting with Mr. Papale.
Yeah, I think it's completely situational. You know, if you're passionate about a career that doesn't involve going to college, then I probably advise someone to not go to college and go to get a trade or whatever that career is, because as good as a lot of the experiences that come with college, obviously there's a financial side to it, and if you go and you don't necessarily utilize it, it could affect, you know, the next few years of your life while you're paying off loans. So I do believe in it if it's the right situation. You know, I'm happy that I had the college experience and got my degree, and I think it helped build some relationships and, you know, start my career. But I think it depends on everybody's personal situation.
That's cool.
I think that college is definitely worth going to, but I also think it definitely depends on, like, the situation that you're in. And if you know if there's a certain opportunity that you have that you don't need to go to college, then I don't think you need to go to college. And I also think that going to college doesn't have to be right after high school. It could be, like we had said, a gap year or even like a couple years later. But I think it's definitely worth going to.
Yeah, same thing. I mean, I think it's not for everybody, and everybody shouldn't go, and there's a lot of people who are very successful that never went to college. In terms of worth, I think there's a lot of really good schools out there that are probably not viewed on the same spectrum as other schools, and I think there's a misconception that a big name school is better than a lesser name school, so I don't think, you know, you have to go to Harvard to be successful. There's a lot of really good schools, and it's like everything else, you get out of it what you put in. So if you go to a community college and you work your butt off and you get good grades, you could still be extremely successful in whatever you do. So it's not where you go, it's what you do.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
I think college has a lot of positives, you know, socially, making connections, meeting new people, putting yourself in a different environment, whether that's closer to home or farther away. But pretty much what everyone's saying, it isn't for everybody, and it's okay that it isn't. You know, there's so many different things that you can do without a college degree. But like I said, you know, there's a lot of positives to it. You know, so it's, again, situational, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. And then Mr. Papale, I know you mentioned like the financial side of college. Were there any like scholarships or any ways that you helped like paying towards your college in high school?
Yeah, I mean, I was definitely pushed by my parents to apply for every, you know, scholarship that, you know, I qualified for based on the qualifications. So, yeah, I definitely was able to get, you know, some financial help with some of the opportunities that Sheehan, you know, offered. But, to answer your question, I did, but, you know, it still was quite the investment beyond that, yeah.
And then the last question is, I've gotten like into a set routine for high school, and I know that it's going to be changing very soon. So how did your daily routine change when you went to college, and starting with Ms. Brown?
My schedule definitely got a lot busier, but in all honesty, it didn't change that much. Like, I still scheduled, like, the way I scheduled my classes were, like, basically in the morning, back to back. And then I'd have practice in the afternoon. So basically in high school, I'd have class all day and I went to practice. So I had a lot more work, which that definitely changed. So I had to have time management. And like when I did have any breaks, I was doing homework, and I still am like doing homework because I'm still in college. But in all honesty, it didn't change that much.
Yeah, I mean, I tried to set my schedule up differently. Like, I would try and have all my classes on, like, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Wednesday nights or something, and have extended weekends, which I wouldn't recommend. The biggest difference is you're more in control of what you're doing, and you can set it up to what you think the best method is for you, so, and what you think might be the best may not be the best. So, I would say, you just make sure you're taking advantage of the free time in between classes. Like if you have a 9 o'clock class and then an 11 o'clock class, rather than going back to the dorm and sleeping for an hour, maybe use that hour to catch up on reading or something, and you're better off. But again, it's all about the personal choices you make.
Let's go.
As far as a routine goes, I mean, if you're living on campus, you're in a different environment. It's going to be a different, I guess, atmosphere. So, you know, your routine is going to be, it's going to change. It's going to take adjustment with anything that becomes different and new. But, you know, to piggyback off of Ms. Brown, you know, I was kind of in the same routine. You understand that you have class, you have, you know, for myself, I had practice, and you have homework to get done or test to study for. But, you know, you also want to make time for your social life. So it is very similar to, I would say, high school.
Yeah, I, you know, agree with what everybody else said, but I definitely think it's a little bit of an adjustment depending on how you build your class schedule. But again, once you get into it, I think it, you know, you do what you think is best for you, and then manage your time, you know, the best you can. So, you know, taking your classes, figuring out when you're going to study, having a plan, sticking to it, I think is the best way to go.
So I'm going to take over for the questioning. So I know, like, throughout all middle school and like pretty much your whole life, you pretty much pick favorites of like what's your favorite thing to do, like what's your favorite class or whatever, what your favorite sport is. Do you have any favorite things that you did in college that you remember from that'll be with you all the time?
Loaded question. Honestly, I mean, I have to say I enjoyed like intramural sports in college the best. That was my favorite. You know, classes are always classes, and you know you're going to do them and you're going to go to them. But just the camaraderie of being on a team and playing with your friends is something that you'll always cherish. So for me, that was my favorite.
Ms. Gill.
I would say that I definitely appreciated how I spent my downtime when I was in college. You know, with peers outside playing can jam, you know, going kayaking, canoeing, just different outdoor activities that I never really tried before here in Wallingford. But, you know, that was definitely something that I enjoy that I picked up and I continue to do now in my life.
Yeah, my best experience that I had in college was I was a student manager for the basketball team, and it built a ton of relationships for me, and like friendships that I'm still, some of my best friends are people that I met during that time. So, you know, I think there's like a lot of athletes want to go to college and play, and then some don't have that opportunity, but the idea of being like a student manager kind of has a negative side to it. And I would just urge, if you have a sport or something that you're passionate about, it's another way to be involved and be a part of a team and you know, still kind of feel that competitive drive that you have.
I agree with like being on a team and just being around people all the time. It, like going into my freshman year, we started out with like preseason, so I was automatically around people like 24/7. So just like kind of going off with what you said about how doing something you're passionate about, that's definitely really important, because I know my favorite thing is just being around people in general, and being on a sports team allowed me to be around people.
Most of you guys have all said that being on a sports, somewhat involved with that, has been part of your favorite. But Ms. Gill, you said about you getting involved with new activities that were outside of school. How did you go about that?
So Springfield has a very unique aspect to it. It has a East Campus, which is basically like an outdoor adventure park. They opened it up for students to go to at certain times. You could actually sign up for canoeing class. So it is very specific to Springfield, but I know most schools, like some of them might have a rock wall. They offer different classes that you probably like never heard before. I know I took a couple fitness classes that I'm like, what the heck am I doing? So there's just so many different opportunities. I know different places like around the area, like, you know, if you go up north anywhere, obviously if you've never skied or snowboard, there's gonna be someone influencing you to try it out. You know, so just try things.
So when you're little and even through high school, you get a school list, a list that people tell you to get before you show up on your first day. For college, you don't really get so much of that. It's kind of just bring what you think you need. Is there any one thing that you recommend, like, that you needed going into college that you didn't have?
It's up to me to start. Well, I can tell you don't need as many clothes as you think you need. You'll probably get 1,000 t-shirts the first couple weeks that you're at school, so don't pack t-shirts. I think like just the everyday things, like, you know, if you track everything that you touch for one day, you know, think about toiletries, everything like that. Obviously you think of those things, but like headphones, different things like that, you know, pictures, anything that you look at that you need in one day being at home, you most likely are going to need it at school.
If I could pick one thing, I would say like cleaning supplies. Like, keep your dorm room as clean as possible. Just because, you know, you're used to living at home, a lot of times that's taken care of for you, and you're going to be on your own, and you don't, you know, you just want to be have a clean place to live and where you can be comfortable. And if you don't have that, you know, if you're having like a bad day or something, you know, you want to go back to your dorm and feel like, you know, it's kind of like a place of comfort for you.
Yeah. I think I'd bring a coffee maker. In my freshman year, I didn't drink coffee, but the past, like, my sophomore and junior year, this year, I drink a lot of coffee, and I definitely spend a lot of money on it. A coffee maker.
I would say a good backpack, because you're basically, you know, when you leave your dorm room in the morning, you're out for the day a lot of times, so the more stuff you can have in your bag that you're going to need throughout the day. I was never a bag person when I was in high school. I'd carry a couple of books home or something, but a backpack for school, whether you're sticking a couple snacks in there, your books, your phone, whatever, that's kind of your life is in that bag.
Coming back to Mr. Papale, so you said about the cleaning and stuff, so I know a lot of parents take care of that for their kids. Is there, like, any one tip you have to do it on your own, the transition?
Yeah, clean often. Clean often, because you're going to have people come to see you, friends, family, like, and, you know, that's an impression people are going to have of you.
So what's one piece of advice that you think you wish you knew before going to college that you didn't already know?
The value of the people, the relationship with the people that you meet, I would say. I met so many great, and I think it starts before college. I think it starts in high school too, but it definitely becomes very important in college and then for the rest of your life. And, you know, learning how to really develop relationships with people, not just like meet somebody, say hi, and never talk to them again, but just, you know, realizing that, you know, the professor that you have, the person that you meet while you're walking across the quad, the person that you meet in the calf could be someone that, you know, could have some sort of benefit on your life. And, you know, understanding that that first impression definitely goes a long way with them.
Kind of going off of that, of like meeting new people and being open to meeting new people, I think something that I wish that I knew in high school and something that I've like been implementing this year in my junior year is just, you're not going to be super close with everybody, but making those friendships of, like you were saying, like just saying hi to them or like getting lunch with them and reaching out to them, that you might not hang out with them ever, like all the time, but just the opportunity to have lunch with them, to meet new people, is important.
I would say don't wish the time away. Like, you know, when you're in your freshman year, you're like, oh my god, 4 years, it's gonna take me 4 years to graduate, and you're like, even when you're in high school, you're like, I can't wait till I'm a senior, and like you spend your whole life saying, I can't wait till I'm here, I can't wait till this is over, and then when you're my age and you look back, you're like, wow, those times were great, I wish I was back there. And you, the whole time you were there, you were wishing you were someplace else. So I would just say that, appreciate where you are and what you're doing, and enjoy the time as you have it, because it's there now and you don't know about tomorrow.
I would say take care of your mental health. I know it's more common now to, you know, take a day for your mental health and do something that you enjoy because you're struggling. You know, I wish I came home a couple extra weekends just to rejuvenate and kind of get back to my center and peace. I could have skipped another class or two, you know, just to keep myself sane and keep myself less stressed. So just take care of yourself and recognize when you need a break, because, you know, in life, like even now, you need a break sometimes.
How did you get to be so comfortable and know yourself to know when you needed a break?
It takes a long time, to be honest with you. It takes quite a bit to recognize in yourself when you're like, you know, wait, I don't feel well, and not even like feeling sick. It's just, I don't feel okay. I need to remove myself from this environment. I need to go to somewhere where I'm comfortable, whether it's your dorm room or back home, or finding a new place on campus that's like your safe place, essentially. But it does take quite a bit of self-reflection, you know, so if you journal, or not even just, you know, taking some time to think, am I happy? You know, what's stressing me out right now? What can I control? What can't I control? And just kind of focusing on what you can control, and if you can control removing yourself from a situation or taking a break, you know, take that advantage.
My bad, put that out. I think can I start with him?
Yeah.
Put it back in.
So I have a sister that's going to college soon, right outside of Boston, and one thing she's really worried about is being homesick. And I know, Ms. Brown, that you mentioned that you miss your family when you're at school. How do you deal with like that homesickness when you're away at college?
I call my parents a lot. I think just having the ability to just kind of either like FaceTime or just call, or if you don't have like an iPhone to like Zoom, I guess, but just having the opportunity to call them or have a set time to call them. I know for me that I'll just call random times, but I think for some people, having like calling like a Sunday at like 3 o'clock, having that set time where you can sit down and just FaceTime your family, that's definitely a tip that I'd recommend.
Yeah, I would say, I mean, I came home a lot because I was at UConn, so it wasn't like a big deal for me, but I think the more comfortable you get with the people that are around you, they become your surrogate family, and it's like anything else. You want to surround yourself with good people, and if you're comfortable with them and they make you feel better, you are less homesick because you feel like you're kind of more at home away from home. So just the more friends you can make and the closer you can get with them, the better off you are.
That's good.
Springfield was an hour north of here, so my mom came up all the time. I could come home with one phone call. But when I studied abroad in Germany, I got really homesick. And, of course, what am I going to do halfway across the world? But I found that phone calls definitely help. Pictures from home. I brought my Shein stuff with me to college, so wearing stuff that reminds me of home. And then connecting with new people and kind of recognizing I need to lean on some other people while I'm here, and they actually might need to lean on you too, so you could be helping each other in that sense.
I was close as well. I mean, Quinnipiac's like 15 minutes from me. But, I think, with the technology that we have, it's, definitely staying in contact with your family and friends that, you're close with. But kind of like what we talked about a little bit before, understanding how you're feeling and accepting that it's okay to be homesick and realizing, okay, I have to do something about this feeling, whether it's making a phone call, whether it's going home, asking your family to come see you. I just think coming to realize, okay, I'm feeling homesick, it's okay, it's a normal feeling to have, and this is how I'm going to make myself feel better about it.
Can I add one more thing to that,
yeah,
too? Because the other thing is that I think the first couple of weeks you're there, the weekend you're probably going to want to come home, but the more you immerse yourself into the environment, the better off you're going to feel. So try not to race home the first time you feel like that, because then it's going to become your crutch.
Mm-hmm.
So battle through the first few times and then see what you feel like after that.
All right. I know kids at Sheehan are feeling a lot less motivated to stay productive during these times. Senioritis is kicking in for you too. How did you guys manage to stay productive and keep yourself immersed in the college community while you were there? So you,
well, I mean, obviously the end goal is to always, you wanted to graduate number one. You wanted to have, decent grades so that when you did graduate, you'd be marketable. So just having goals and making sure you're working towards achieving those goals is really the biggest thing, because no one else is going to set them for you. I'm sure everyone's parents are going to be on them about their grades and stuff, but you should all set your own goals of what you want out of your experience and out of your life and work towards those.
Absolutely. I mean, as an adult, I'm constantly making new goals for myself. So it's a good way to start in high school and in college to set goals, whether they're little or big. I know sometimes your goal might be to get out of bed for the day and go study, and that's okay that's a little goal, but just setting those little goals to reach that big goal.
So yeah, I mean, I obviously agree with that. I would say another thing is just like having a little bit of personal pride as well. Like when you put your name on an assignment or a project or anything that you do, it kind of reflects on you as a person. So doing the best you can and trying to give the best quality assignment or whatever it is that you're doing, I think, is what something that motivated me at least.
I agree with having goals and writing them down, but I also, we mentioned using like a planner before, but just having like using a planner and having all your work written down in it. I'm big on sticky notes and to-do lists, so just having something that you can like write on and cross out, and just seeing that you're crossing things off, that'll keep you motivated.
Alright, when it comes to like college and high school in general, you usually like take away one big lesson. What's the one like overall grasp or idea that you took out of college or high school? We'll start with Ms. Gill.
I'll go back to Springfield. I love it there. But their like theme or kind of message that they send to all of their students is spirit, mind, and body, and kind of accepting that, you know, to live like a balanced life, recognize your spirit, your mind, and your body. And I kind of find myself incorporating that message into anything that I do, whether it's my job, whether it's coaching, my relationships with people, my goals for myself. So I guess my biggest thing was just kind of figuring out who you were in college. Like, yeah, in high school you kind of have a set group, but in college there's so many more people. You're going to find your place. You're going to find people that mean something to you. So just figuring out who you are and what you want to be and how you want to be in life.
Mr. Rappel, I know this changed midway through high school for you. What was the biggest thing you took away from your story?
A couple of things. So, you know, I had, like I said, I was focused on basketball. Went into cardiac arrest before my senior year of high school, and I couldn't play basketball anymore. So it completely, like, flipped my whole life around. I think it gave me some, like, purpose and allowed me to figure out really what I wanted to do with my life at a young age, which I don't think a lot of people are lucky enough to kind of realize what they're super passionate about. I would say the biggest thing I would learn from that is to live life in a way that when you look back on the different things and the different phases of your life, you don't, like, wish you did certain things. Because once, like, different phases of your life go by, kind of like what you said before, you can't get them back. And you don't want to sit here and say, oh, I wish I did this when I was back in college, or I wish I was, you know, worked harder at this back in high school or whatever it is. Because once it ends, you know, it's a sad reality, but it ends and you have to move on and do different things. So I would say that's the biggest thing I learned from, you know, that experience. But to your original question, I would say, like, in college, a big thing that I learned was I heard a speaker that came to our school that said two things you need to do in life to be successful is work hard and be nice to people. It's like something that's, like, resonated with me, like, my whole life, because I truly feel like you have complete control over both. That's a fact. How hard you work, and, you know, people like being around other nice people. So, like, it could help you get a job, it could help you move up in a job, if you can, you know, work harder than everybody and just be nice to people while you do it.
Ms. Brown?
I think the biggest thing that I learned in high school and that I'm learning now in college is that you mentioned this, but it goes by so fast, and, like, those 4 years in both high school and college, they're just gone in an instant. And I think it's hitting me now that I'm going into my senior year that, looking back, like, I already finished high school and I'm almost done with college, and, like, that's just crazy. But just taking advantage of all the opportunities, and, like, you obviously don't want to say yes to everything, but you want to try new things, it'll allow you to meet new people.
I would say to define your own success. Like, don't, when you're judging yourself on whether you're successful or not, like, you're going to measure yourself against other people, whether it's financially or career-wise or anything, and what makes you happy isn't necessarily what makes him happy. So you have to figure out what makes you the happiest and what is going to make your life successful. And it's not about dollars or houses or cars or anything else. It's about whatever is meaningful to you. So whether that's family or, you know, passionate about your work, but just find what will make you feel successful and be happy with that, and don't measure yourself by other people's standards.
All right. Now, I know all of you guys went to school relatively close to Connecticut. How do you think it would have impacted you if you were to go out further and branch out to, let's say, like, the West Coast? We'll start with you, Mr. Bell.
I think it would be a great opportunity to be able to experience living in a different part of the country. I think a lot of times, like, I've done this, so I'm probably I'm kind of going against what I've done, but, like, I think it's, you know, you grow up in a certain area and you're kind of only know what it's like here, and I think there's so much out there that the country has to offer. And I think if you have an opportunity to travel for school, go somewhere different, go to the West Coast, go somewhere, I think it's definitely a great opportunity.
I think it's definitely a great opportunity to go out of state for school, or even in state. Is going to college is a good opportunity in general, but I think that I go to school in Pennsylvania, which isn't super, super far, like, it's not the West Coast, but I don't regret going to school like 5 hours away. I think it allows me to, kind of like what you were saying, it allows me to see everything kind of from like a new perspective and meet new opportunities in a new place that I'm not used to. It just allows you to grow out of your comfort zone, and as you get like older in life, you're not going to be living in your comfort zone all the time. So it teaches you a lot.
Yeah, I was going to say, the nice thing about college is you get people from all over coming to where you are. So while it would be nice to go and experience another, you know, setting, you can also experience other people's version of life just by being around them. Because people are throughout the country. I mean, I've worked in a lot of different places, and you know, the people from the Midwest are a lot different than we are. I mean, they're just their pace in life is different. And, like, people from the Northeast are always like, they're so like super aggressive, and like I find myself finishing people's sentences at work because they're just more laid back, and it's just a different way of life. So just learning more about those different aspects are interesting, and you know, you just have to be able to, you know, to get a taste for all of it. And I don't know if you need to go to school, you know, far away to learn that, or you can just, you know, go visit. But yeah, it's different in different parts of the country, so it's good to get a taste for all of it.
School's a big decision, you know, so like choosing a school across the country might be tough for somebody who can't get out there to go visit it. And obviously New England, there's tons of colleges around the area. The one thing I tell any senior, I'm like, study abroad. At some point, try and study abroad, whether it's a summer program, a semester, a whole year, because it does get you out of your comfort zone. But I think the biggest lesson that it teaches is that you are really the only one you can 100% count on, and it kind of teaches you to become an advocate for yourself, to problem solve for yourself, especially when you're by yourself in a new place. It's just, I think, like, the reason I grew so much was because I put myself out of my comfort zone, studying abroad with literally nobody that I knew, and I'm like, hey, let's go to Germany, you know? But it's, you have to get out of your comfort zone and be able to grow. But you don't necessarily have to go to school somewhere far, far away for that to happen.
All you guys are great.
Yeah, that was amazing. It went by pretty fast. And thank you all for coming to our program today. And thank you to all seniors that submitted questions. I just want to leave everyone with this quote that I wrote down from Mr. Mackenzie that just stuck with me. But well, he said, it's not where you go, it's what you do. I just thought, my parents said a similar thing. It's, you were talking about getting, it's not like the name brand school like Harvard. You could go anywhere and you could be as successful as you want to be. It's what you put into college, what you get out. And that really stuck with me. And I enjoyed what you said about that.
Well, I'm glad.
And thank you again for coming today. And thank you for watching.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, thank you.